Hello, Power Nerds Lightning Collection fans, and welcome to the next chapter of the Lightning Library, the series where we take a detailed look at every entry in the Lightning Collection to talk about the history behind them, take a look at them individually, and what I think of them. And today, we are taking a look at the next entry here from the 2020 releases, Wave 5, which came out in June, technically May, technically July, but mainly June of 2020, and consisted of Time Force Red, Mighty Morphin Blue, Zeo Gold, Treo Triforia version, and Ranger Slayer. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the history and release of this wave before we take a look at each figure individually.
The story of Wave 5 began on the same night that we saw the Walmart listings for Wave 3 and Wave 4 uncovered. August 16th, 2019, following those waves being uncovered by at Power Your Talk, later on in the night at Razzle 1337, decided to join in the fun when they posted their own findings for the night. Right at midnight on August 17th, Raz posted a listing for Romeo Silver, and then shortly after, SPC Beta Romeo and TF Roger Romeo. Quickly, fans figured out that SPC Beta was MMPR Blue, based off of the codes found earlier in the night. TF was assumed to be Time Force, alongside Roger being Red. And with this code system having each code name start with the same letter as its actual name for the most part, Romeo Silver was assumed to be Ranger Slayer. At this point, only 3/4 of the listings for Wave 5 were found and posted. However, a fourth listing was prematurely added to the group. Only a few hours before Raz uncovered Wave 5, at Power Ranger Talk had posted part of a bill of lading with a figure coded SPC Vulcan on it. It wasn't called out at first, but SPC Vulcan was later found to actually be the code for the GameStop exclusive Goldar figure, and being found on the same night as all these other codes, it was grouped in alongside Wave 5 to complete a full Wave of 4. Now, since Wave 5 would be so far away in terms of releasing, not a lot of news happened for a decent amount of time. While it would not get as much traction or coverage as the initial listing leak, the proper fourth code for the Wave would be found and posted by Raz on September 25th to be Zip Grizzly Romeo, which following codes would be the Zeo Gold figure. From the moment this was found, people were hoping that this release would be different in some fashion compared to the San Diego Comic-Con version that had just been released that past summer. Heading later into the fall, the reveals and controversies around Waves 3 and 4 would take up most of the spotlight, but Wave 5 still found its way to be relevant at times. The same weekend that the SPD Red Ranger figure was announced, Entertainment Earth had put up a pre-order page for Mighty Morphin Blue, listed for a June release way too early. The Wave lineup would be reinforced and code assumptions would be confirmed later in November when a distributor website listed the case breakdown alongside Wave 4's full case breakdown. A few months later, it was time for Wave 5 to be revealed soon. On February 18th, in the days leading up to New York Toy Fair 2020, at Uncaged Otaku found Wave 5 in the Target system for a June 1st release and once again reinforced this lineup. The day before the Toy Fair panel on February 21st, at JT Prime 17 posted the first look at the Wave via the Walmart app updating their pictures. Better images would be found on both Amazon Canada and Amazon Italy the following morning, right before the reveal.
We're also going to ask you to pretend that everything we're going to show you, you're totally not aware of and it didn't leak and you're going to be really excited and you're going to be like, hell yeah! So what we're going to have up first, let's take a look at the first figure that we're going to reveal here.
Finally, on Saturday, February 22nd, 2020, half a year after the listings were found, Wave 5 was finally revealed to the world and put up for pre-order. This wave would feature a case assortment of 3 Time Force Reds, 2 Mighty Morphin Blues, 2 Zeo Golds, and 1 Ranger Slayer. The Zeo Gold figure would differ from the STCC version though, by being based off of the Treo Triforia character instead of the Jason character, which would mean coming with a Trey head and a new version of the Golden Power Staff that was missing from the convention set. On May 5th, a little less than a month before the wave was slated to be released, Hasbro Pulse put out emails claiming it would be delayed from June 1st to July 1st. In a classic Lightning Collection fashion, neither date would be the first time that people would get their figures, as they showed up in Australia on May 14th at the store Angel Grove Collectibles. In the US though, the wave would start shipping and arriving for people from both Amazon and Target during the first week of June, leaving Pulse just slacking behind, while some of the boxes from Amazon were pretty badly beaten up. This was also the very first wave whose release was covered on the first episode of my series on this channel, Lightning Storm, so we are finally in the Lightning Storm era of the Lightning Collection's history.
Our first figure up in the wave is Time Force Red, Wesley Collins here, looking really, really great. He's our token, 3 per case of the wave and our Red Ranger. So of course, like usual, we're going to take a look at the box render compared to the actual figure. So one thing that's actually interesting between the box render and the actual figure is that usually I try to recreate the render like pose as best as I can, but you actually technically cannot perfectly recreate it because here on the pose, he's holding the sword with his thumbs up finger, which you do get that hand. You get the thumbs up hand. However, I mean, it's a closed fist hand for the thumbs up, so it's actually impossible to do that. So I don't know what the heck happened there, but you actually cannot perfectly recreate this pose. But for the most part, there's really no other difference between like the actual render here and the final figure as much as I can see. So let's go ahead and get into the details of it. But of course, we're going to take just a real quick look at the Tom Whalen box art that Wes does have here. So, you know, pretty standard, typical Lightning Collection fare here. Nothing too surprising. So Wes does come with a couple of things here. So we can see here, first of all, here is his articulation chart that I'll be putting up here. I got a lot of requests to bring back the articulation chart in terms of the new format. So that's how we will be doing this. So he has his Chrono Blaster, which I believe is a Time Force exclusive weapon that we only ever saw him use. The only time I can remember him using it in Ranger form was during Reinforcements from the Future. So maybe there's another time I can't think of, but he does come with that, but since it was kind of a Time Force exclusive weapon, there's no like holster for him or anything like that. So either you have him hold it or you just kind of find a place for it. So, but you can see obviously he has a holding hand there and a holding hand there. His other two hands, one is just a regular fist for his right hand. And then like I had already stated, you get that thumbs up hand for his left hand. So nothing super crazy there. So as you can see, classic Lightning Collection paint applications. Look how like cracked up the white is on his chest there. And obviously it is a complaint that the arrow is like too narrow, especially on the line that goes down there. And theoretically, to be like completely show accurate, it should probably continue onto the shoulders a little bit, under the butterfly joints. Also the helmet, look how not lined up that is. You see that silver stripe right down there? It just, like, you can see the indent of where it's supposed to be, but it doesn't perfectly get there. So you have like this kind of lopsided arrow, which from a distance doesn't look too horrible, but I mean, I definitely cannot unsee that. taking a look at his weapon here. So his effect piece is this yellow wraparound effect piece that we've had in, by the time that this figure had come out, we had it in purple with the GameStop exclusive Goldar. And now we have it in yellow here, which is really only good for one of his Chrono Sabers, which the Chrono Sabers do combine. There's just a little peg at the bottom there for them to peg in together there. Or you can, of course, have them separated so you can give one to each hand. And they're very nice with the clear plastic and everything. The black on the handle is surprisingly not that kind that like chips off very easily. I have never had any problems with them chipping off, to be honest. So that's very, very nice because usually when the weapons are painted at the handle and not molded in that color, they chip off in the figure's hands, and you also just drop it on the floor sometimes like I just did. So there is the Jason Font head there, which I don't think it's too bad. It's not probably one of the like all-time greatest Lightning Collection heads, but for the most part, I don't think it's too bad. There is the West head. Next up, we have the Mighty Morphin Blue Ranger, Billy here. So for the most part, there's really no difference between the 3D render on the box and the final figure, except for the obvious shade in blue. So the actual figure is a lot darker of a blue, which is more accurate, I would say, to this very light blue that they used on the back render here, which is just kind of weird that they did that way. But obviously, there's not much to say about the box in general here, just pretty standard stuff there. There is the Tom Whalen box art on there as well. So you get pretty much the standard typical male Mighty Morphin stuff. So you are going to get the Blade Blaster and only its blaster mode, which can just fit right there into his holster like usual. You get the Triceratops coin molded on the Power Morpher on his buckle there. You get the Power Lance. So we've had the Power Lance before. We had them in the SDCC Jason 2-pack when they came with the full Power Blaster. And these are the ones that came, or basically the ones that came in Nats. So they were the smaller, like, individual ones for the Power Blaster. Now you get those here, and then you also get them combined. So instead of just including, like, this middle piece where they could, like, peg in or something, they ended up giving you both options in the same figure. So that's pretty cool. So this is the only way to get the combined, like, huge big lance is with the Mighty Morphin Blue figure. And it does look pretty, pretty nice. You get the, holding hands on both hands, and then his other hands, very uncreative, but they're just fists. Nothing too creative there. Here is his articulation chart that I'll put up here for a minute. So, obviously, basic articulation, like, nothing that you'd be super surprised about him having or not having. His effect piece is also one we've had before many times. This is the same kind of effect piece we had in red with Lord Zedd from Wave 1. We also had it in a dark gold with the Zeo Gold figure from the Comic-Con 2-pack, and we've had it in many different colors since then. So here it is in a light blue for the first time. And there is the Billy head, which is based off of course, Season 1 with the glasses and everything like that. Myself and many other people are hoping that we could get, like, a metallic armor blue someday that would have Billy without his glasses, since that was kind of his major look through, like, Season 2, 3, and Zeo. So there's a lot of glare coming up on those glasses there, but overall, I don't think the head is too horrible. I think over time it gets a little worse, maybe, but it's not like the worst head ever. Next up is our Zeo Gold Tray of Triforia version. So, you know, it was interesting that we got this figure so soon after the Comic-Con release of it, but there are some differences between that version and this version to discuss. Spoiler alert, the Comic-Con one is standing there in the corner, but there is the, you know, detail look-ish at the box. So you do get new Tom Whalen artwork with this one, since the Comic-Con one had the 2-pack style where it was facing straight on forward, but here you get the normal single release style. So it is also exclusive box art if you want that, if that's, you know, enough of a reason to buy it a second time if you didn't get the Comic-Con set. That's another reason to buy it. So taking a look at it, first of all, we'll take this off because it barely wants to stay on as it is. This is a yellow version of the effect piece that we just had with the MMPR Blue Ranger in blue. Here it is in yellow, which is actually a different color than it was in the Comic-Con set. So in the original Zeo Gold came with the same exact effect piece, but it was done up in a lot darker, almost like an orange color. And here it's in this, like, bright yellow. So interestingly, this is actually the only way to get this one in this color. So that's technically an exclusive piece to this re-release, which makes, like, 3 total exclusive pieces. So in the Comic-Con set, there was 2 versions of the Golden Power Staff that were exclusive to that set. This one is a 3rd exclusive version. So in the Comic-Con set, there is a version where this silver piece was up like it is right now, but the gold symbol was closed. Then there was also a version in the Comic-Con set where this gold piece was down and this was open. So, and then this version is the only way to get it with the silver piece in the middle and this open. So technically, there is a 4th version that, like, hasn't been released, I suppose, where it would be, like, the only other combination of those 4 that hasn't been a thing. But we only get this version here, but like I said, it is exclusive to this release, so if you want all the versions or all the accessories, you're gonna have to get this re-release. but for the most part, taking a look and bringing in the actual figure, I don't know why he's posed so weird. Here is the Comic-Con version, the Jason 2-pack version, and here is the Trey version. Now, at first glance, they probably look the exact same. I'd say the most noticeable difference to tell which one is which is down here at the boots. The Comic-Con one is a lot more of a gold paint down there, while this one's a lot more of a dull gold. I don't know how well that's coming off at all. It probably looks the exact same to you. But in person, there's definitely a difference between the shade right down there at the boot cuffs that lets me know which one is which. Same thing at the wrists. This one's a lot more of a lighter cold gold than this one. So, like, to me, I can definitely tell the difference in person. But for the most part, you are getting the same figure, which, I mean, of course you are. There's really no reason for you not to be. His alternate hands are just fists, just like Billy's were, so nothing super crazy there. But what is really cool, and probably my favorite part about them, how they did this, not only did they give you that new version of the Golden Power Staff, but they actually went the extra mile to give you, if I can get it to go on all the way, they actually went through the extra mile, come on, the Tray of Triforia head instead of Jason. So that is really cool. So you even have the scar over his eye and everything. Like, yeah, that's how you were supposed to do this. They really got it right. So, you know, re-release a con figure, a conventional figure, but make it different enough to make it, like, justifiable to buy it a second time. This is a different character than the original one. So, in my mind, it's completely valid. Now, here's his articulation chart. And finally, we conclude the wave with the Ranger Slayer from the Boom Studios comics. So at the time, this was the second Boom Studios figure that they had released alongside with after they did Lord Draken in Wave 3. But this figure right here was the first time we ever had any kind of physical figure for Ranger Slayer from the comics, which was really, really cool that they did that. So taking a look at the render to the figure, I don't really see much of a difference between the two. For the most part, I think that they replicated it nearly perfectly, except I just noticed, you see the pink trim on her foot there? Not present on the final release. So, of course, you get the render, you get Tom's beautiful box art all over the place there. I mean, this is just a really, really cool suit. It's a really, really cool figure, and I love that we got it, even though I understand why it is a one per case, because, I mean, it's a little bit more involved, obviously, than a typical figure. So, let's take a look at the effect piece really quick. Get it off the finger there. So this is the same effect piece we got with the original Mighty Morphin Pink, but in that release it was a light pink color. This one is definitely a darker pink, basically like a hot pink color. So it is definitely for sure different than that. Also very similar, so the original Mighty Morphin Pink had an arrow for her power bow. This time you get that, but you get like this triple arrow piece. So it is, you know, a new arrow piece than we've had from that one, which goes perfectly with her bow of darkness, which we can take out of her hand real quick here. This does suffer that problem where holding it makes it chip. You can see there's black paint already chipped off of there. But for the most part, the bow of darkness looks very good. It's basically two swords of darkness, like, glued together. So there's a little port here, right there, this little hook. So that way you can take the arrow pieces and clip them in. So that's very cool. It makes it very helpful if you're trying to do some kind of dynamic pose, so that way the arrows are not gonna fall out or anything. A tactic that Psycho Pink's bow will use later on in the 5-pack, which hint hint is next week's video. So for the most part though, this figure is really cool. So here's kind of her typical like holding hands. The other hands she gets is she gets a fist for her right hand, and she gets this like karate chop hand for her left hand. So nothing super crazy there. The cape is removable. It doesn't click in or anything. It's just kind of held there by friction. So it comes off. It's that rubbery kind of plastic, basically the exact same material that Magnet Offenders was in Wave 2. And you get that nice little pink paint there up at the shoulder. And you get the kind of frayed edges there and the little holes and everything. So, but if you want to take that off to kind of get a better look at the whole suit, you can definitely do so. It's very nicely painted and stuff underneath the cape, parts that you wouldn't normally see. Her Power Morpher has the pterodactyl coin and everything in there. Very, very nicely painted and sculpted. You actually get the Blade Blaster in its holstered mode in black, which is accurate to the comic suit, but this is actually the first time, besides the Comic-Con set, that we had the Blade Blaster in its holstered mode. So you get this very nice raised pattern there, painted beautifully. You get the little, like, I like this detail. You get these little like battle scratches and damages in her her armor down there, which is really, really neat, I think. And her head, for some reason, it feels like very loose on there, but I don't really know what that's about. But I mean, it's perfectly good. It can come off and everything. However, you do not get a World of the Coinless Kimberly head with this, unfortunately. I would very much have appreciated that to have been a thing, because I like when the figures come with civilian heads, but we did not get a Kimberly head with this. So granted, there are other ways we can get a head for a coinless Kimberly. There is another Ranger Slayer form in the comics from her own like mini-series, as well as we could also get her as the Pink Solar Ranger if they ever want to go down that route as well. But this was her base form in the comics, the Mighty Morphin Ranger Slayer, which is just probably one of the most badass comic designs in my opinion, and I'm really happy that it came to the Lightning Collection. Overall, Wave 5, I feel, is extremely, extremely great. I like the lineup of this wave, like, a lot. It might be my favorite wave as of this point. Wave 8 is a very solid contender, and Wave 9's lineup is fantastic, too. But I really like what we got going on here. So it was always cool, of course, to get another Red Ranger. It was nice to continue our Mighty Morphin team, since we were, at this point, very close to finishing the core team. It was great for people who didn't get the Comic-Con set to get Zeo Gold, and if you did get the Comic-Con set, it was great to have all those differences to make it worth it to buy it again. And of course, getting Ranger Slayer was fantastic. I always like whenever we get more comic figures, hopefully we get more in the future. But yeah, overall, this wave was just very solid. So as of the time of this recording, I think you can still get this wave mostly. I know Ranger Slayer is kind of hard to get because she was the one per case. Mighty Morphin Blue is kind of hard to get because people were buying up the Mighty Morphin team to complete that. But I think Time Force Red and even I think regular Zeo Gold, I think, are still reasonably easy to find. So you just shouldn't be too difficult. As of the time of this video coming out, the wave's not even a year old. It's only about 9 months old at this point. So it should be really, you know, relatively easy to find. But that will do it for this chapter of the Lightning Library. Stay tuned for next week, where we will be taking a look at our very first 5-pack in the Lightning Collection, the Psycho Ranger Team Pack. So, I'll see you guys next time.